Alrighty, I am back, and today I felt like playing more Bloodborne, so we are going to do the second part of the Forbidden Woods today. So anyway, last time, we went through the first part of the Forbidden Woods. That was a little bit of fun. I guess I'm still using the saw blade. Maybe I'll use the cane a little bit. Maybe not. Don't know yet. Sorry, I've been playing a little bit of Dark Souls too, just reorienting my controls. But to the Forbidden Woods it is. Sorry, I had to get up and adjust something. But yeah, I was playing some Dark Souls 2, so I gotta get used to my controls again. Oh, good old woods. I have to play Doom a little bit. Oh, that's kinda loud. Hold on. There we go. Silly crow. You will not knock me down. I will have vengeance. But yeah, I figured today I'd go through the Forbidden Woods, do the Shadows of Yharnam and whatnot. That guy's usually up here. No shield. Weapon transformation. Anyway. So yeah, my friend went back to college. So he went back to college in Philly. I guess I'm not going to see him for a little bit unless I go to Philly. And my other friend's 21st is coming up tomorrow, so we're going to be at the casino. We're going to be downtown partying it up. It's going to be a fun time. But yeah, other than that, I haven't really been doing too much. Hey guy, come here. There we go. Get my visceral down. A little visceral practice. And I believe I went through this first part last time. Not entirely sure. I know over here leads you to somewhere else. But, yeah. I actually kind of wanted to talk about friendship today a little bit and how I've noticed friendship changing a little bit throughout the years and what friendship means. Hold on a second. But the way I was raised, I guess, friendship was a pretty much... Oh, no, you didn't. Friendship was not what it is now. It seems like nowadays friendship is almost... Oh, there goes a plane. You can probably hear the plane. Hold on, I want to see if I can hear the plane. Yeah, you can hear the plane. Anyway, sorry. Seems like any more friendship went from being two people that have common interests and common ground with each other that like to hang out and do similar things, to a mutual acquaintanceship based off what one person can do to the other. And what I mean by that is, like, when I was a little kid and I was making friends and whatnot, I didn't make my friends based off the strength of what I thought I could get out of them. Like, whether it be things like, I mean, drugs and sex didn't matter back then, so... Like, I wasn't like, oh, I'm going to be friends with him because he has the best Pokemon cards or something like that. But that just seems to be what it's turned into. Like, people who only want to hang out with you when one of you guys has weed and shit like that. And it's kind of, like, upsetting to see the fact that nobody is truly anybody else's friend anymore. It's more of like, what can this person give me, and what benefit do I get hanging out with them and spending my time with them? Because everybody nowadays feels like they are some awesome individual that's destined for greatness, that is entitled to everything and anything. And it's just kind of sickening. Like, the fact that I watch friendships get broken up over such stupid shit. And people not like each other over such stupid shit and such pettiness. And I guess my idea of friendship is, it's pretty much somebody that you respect and love as a person that you want to see and help do well, and who wants the same for you. And that's pretty much my definition of friendship. And the more I look around and the more I see, I don't see that anymore. Hold on. Had to put out my cigarette. Yeah, but what I see is, what can I get out of this person? And if I can't get anything out of them, what is the point in hanging out with them? Sorry, I just wanted to call. Sidebar real quick. I just wanted to defeat a couple enemies to get back in my garage. Now I'm gonna go take the shortcut back. But yeah, it seems like almost as if it's, what can I get out of that person, instead of how can we get along and how can we relate. It's no longer about friends being friends and doing friend things. Like, a lot of the people I know won't even hang out with you if one of you doesn't have weed. Excuse me. If one of you doesn't have weed or some kind of drug, and that in itself is disturbing, because it annoys me to see things like that. Because what's the point? If you only wanted me for my weed, why are we even so-called friends? But that's the way a lot of friendships work nowadays. Or it's like all drug-based, and maybe it's just the area that I live in. Oh, what's... Oh, shit. Damn, that took a minute to render. Hopefully I got that on camera. Anyway. But yeah, like, things just aren't what they used to be, and it's sad. And, like, when I was growing up, me and my friends, we would go outside and play and, you know, have a good time and just enjoy the company of each other. And now it doesn't seem to be like that at all. It seems to just be drug-based, like the area that I live in. Everything is just so drug-based, and it's just so annoying, because it's like, if you don't have drugs, nobody will hang out with you. And like I keep saying, that might just be the area in which I live, but it's kind of saddening and depressing to see what these things have become. And you can actually see those little blue guys down there. Anyway, yeah, so I wanted to talk about, like, I don't know what I wanted to talk about. I just kind of wanted to vent, like, that it upsets me, because, like, two of my best friends aren't best friends anymore because of a female, and I get that that happens, like, all the time and whatnot, but it's not like it's never happened before. What I'm saying is, it's becoming a much, much, much more common occurrence. Like, one of my favorite phrases to say is, these dudes ain't loyal, but be the first to go to war for a chick with no morals. And what I mean is, you can have a ride or die best friend that you've been through thick and thin for fucking years on end. Like, a couple of friends I have been. And all of a sudden, one of you guys falls in love, and you guys hate each other because of things the female is saying. And I'm not talking about how females ruin relationships or anything like that. That is not what I'm saying. What I am saying is, it seems to be more and more commonplace that males are willing to give up friendships for females. And I don't know if I know a lot of people are going to say, oh, it's just because the pussy that good, blah, blah, blah. Like, nah, it ain't like that. Like, people seem to be just throwing away years of friendship over instant gratification and instant things, and it's just so annoying. Because it's like, yo, like, perfect example is me and my one friend. Like, we've been friends for 15 plus years. We only stopped being friends this year, and yeah, it's kind of a long story with us. His mom actually started babysitting me when we were way younger, but it goes, sorry, I got a burp. It goes way before that, because back in the day, Pop Dukes, he was OG. Pretty much my dad's been here all of his life, and he like myself, or me like him rather, we were both drug dealers back in the day, and apparently he has sold some drugs to his parents, and that's how we ended up knowing each other, because she was like, hey, I have this baby, like, you know, when everything was done, everybody was like, hey, I have this babysitting service, I know you have kids or whatever, and I just ended up going there because my dad knew him. Anyway, that's besides the point, but, you know, we became best friends. We've been through everything together, thick and thin. Like, we ended up getting addicted to opiates together. We were together every day. We lived together for a while. You know, we were just boys, man. Like, we always had each other's back, no matter what. We were always riding for each other. Like, yo, if he was about to fight someone out in public, I was about to fight someone out in public. If I was about to fight someone out, he was about to fight someone out. You know what I mean? Like, it was just our ride-or-die homeboy relationship. And, you know, there was drugs involved, but it wasn't... The drugs weren't the center of it at the time. And so, you know, we're just friends for years, and it just continues on like that for years. And then all of a sudden, one day, one of us gets a girlfriend. And it was me who got the girlfriend first, and... You know, I tried to, let me rephrase. We both got a girlfriend at around the same time. And it was weird because I watched it happen with both of us. Like, our girlfriends didn't like each other. Like, my girlfriend didn't like him, and his girlfriend didn't like me. And so, that was the first time I realized I was succumbing to something like that. I hung out with him less and less and less, and he also hung out with me less and less and less because we both had girlfriends. And, you know, I understand people going off and doing their own things in life and friendship forever and all that, but... I realized what was happening, and I was, you know, I confronted him about it. I was like, yo, like, our bitches hate each other. They don't want us hanging out with either of us because they hate each other. And, you know, that was the first time I had someone that I had put my faith in that deeply not listen to what I had to say. And he was like, oh, no, you're wrong, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, no, dude, it's clearly happening. He's just kind of like... fuck you, dude, whatever, like, I don't care, I got my bitch, fuck you, and I'm just like, okay, but that was the first time that something like that had happened, and this ties around into my friendship, because, lo and behold, when him and that girlfriend broke up, who did he run to? Me. Oh, Ian, I'm so sorry, blah, 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 and my point is, you know, I forgave him the first time or whatever, and now he's done that like 15 times at this point, but my point is, it seems like stuff like that is becoming more and more commonplace, like, just, that's okay for people to do. People just take each other for granted anymore, and friendship actually isn't about friendship, it's about what can so-and-so do for me. Like, he didn't want to be lonely. I could help him by not being lonely because he was so used to having that girl. And he, you know, for first time I learned my lesson, we became best friends again after that, after they had broke up or whatever, even though I still had my girlfriend. Yeah, we had become best friends after that again. And, you know, we were hanging out every day again. Same thing happened again just recently. Except, he had went to Florida for a little bit. Basically, he got into some real sour shit. He ended up doing a couple armed robberies, and I ended up, keeping him at my house until he was able to get out of the state. And he got out of the state and went to a, rehab in Florida, and I still talk to him every day and everything like that, but, oh shit, I forgot all about him. But anyway, so he went to rehab in Florida, and he ended up getting the same shit down there, and he ended up getting shot up. Like, my man got lit up. And so, he comes back here or whatever after gets lit up, and that didn't have to do with him getting lit up. It had to do with his probation wouldn't let him transfer down there. Anyway, shit, my doorbell's ringing, and I forgot you can't pause this game. I don't really care if you ring my doorbell, but fuck that, I got that train of thought. Shit. Oh, yeah, he came back from Florida. His probation transfer. And he didn't have anything up here. Because what he did to me, he also did to everybody else up here. And I was the only one willing to give him a second chance. And so, well, he did it to everybody else a lot worse up here, too. Like, he started stealing shit and everything, but that's besides the point. So, I gave him a second chance or whatever, and the dude who he was living with in Florida, what the fuck? What are you getting hurt on, bud? Oh, you're in the fire. Haha, you're in the fire. Oh, no monocular. See, that's how you do it. Super pro elite right there. Anyway. So he ended up living with some dude in Florida, and then once he left that dude in Florida, he is 40-year-old, he's gay, and I do not have anything against gay people, that just comes into play later in the story, but so he is gay, and he left Florida. He was living with this gay dude in Florida that picked him up off the street while he was all bloody, walking away from the hospital because they just stabilized him and left because he didn't have insurance. But anyway. Oh my god. I'll edit this out. Hello? I actually just received the phone call that I edited out. Anyway, like I was saying. So he comes back here from Florida. You know, he's done everybody in the world dirty up here, stolen so much shit, all that shit. He was just a bad person, and I'm the only one who'll take him in. So things are going good for a little bit. I introduce him to my friends or whatever like that. No, everything's going good. Things are like old times again. Haha, good times were had by all. He's sober. And yeah. And so, sometime along the timeline, the guy that he was in Florida with, this 40-year-old gay guy, who was a professor at a college, nonetheless, he has some type of weird mental breakdown snap out because my friend left him down there. He felt abandoned, apparently. And so he snaps out, moves up here, lives with him and his family. And my friend was clean until he came back up. Bull brought a bunch of dope back with him. And this is a 40-year-old college professor, brings a bunch of heroin back with him and gets my boy re-addicted. So, you know, I'm on the sidelines. I'm okay, you know, grown men make their own decisions. You know, who am I to, all I can do is lead the horse to water. I can't make it drink. So, you know, things are okay. I'm like, you know, dude, I'm cool with it or whatever, as long as you don't, you know, snap out and do all your crazy shit again while the dude's living up here or whatever. And, you know, things are going good for a while. So, we're partying with my friends. Gay dude has a freak out one day. And I say gay dude in a non-derogatory term. I'm calling him gay dude to describe who he was. He was the gay dude. And that plays a part in my story. Anyway, so he has a freak out or whatever one night. Just straight freaks out, starts smashing shit at my friend's house, embarrassing all my friends or whatever. And it just was not a good time. So we... Hold on, yeah, it is an item. Anyway. So, you know, I'm like, okay, things are okay, things happen or whatever, and my friend ends up meeting a girl there that night. That girl there happened to be the crew host, you know, who, you know, fucked everybody, fucks for drugs, everything. Well, my friend's feeling kind of low, and now he's taking a dope once again. Wow, they got me. He's addicted to dope once again, and he is lonely. So what's he do? He gets the girl addicted and starts dating the girl. I am not one to stand on the sidelines. Me being what I think is a good friend, start calling everybody out on how that is wrong. Yo, this is wrong. This shouldn't be going on. Like, this is what's going on here. Nobody wants to hear it, in my opinion. I'm a horrible person. Keep telling the dude, well, the gay guy, he tells Sam, after I snap out, I'm like, yo, this is fucked up, I know exactly what's going on here. Gay dude, gets mad at me because I snapped on him for giving, my friend dope. I was like, yo, like, you know exactly what you're fucking doing. He's trying to make my boy, dependent upon him, so he always needs him. And that's the gay guy. Anyway. So, I pretty much called out. Gay dude gets mad at me. I'm like, he starts saying, oh, it's just because I'm gay, this, that, and the third. I said, dude, I don't give a fuck if you're gay. Half my fucking homies are gay. I got no fucking problem with gay people. You like what you like. That's how I was raised, but that's a whole different fucking story. You like what you like. Anyway, and that's what I believe. Anyway, so my friend... I gotta concentrate on fighting this dude. I gotta... Aw, I missed. Fuck. I forgot how hard that was. There we go. Give me some Quicksilver bullets, please. Anyway. So, gay dude came back from Florida, got my friend re-addicted to heroin. My friend is dating the crew whore, got her addicted to heroin. They're all addicted to heroin at this point. I snap out, yo, this isn't cool. I know exactly what you're doing. Now, my friend, he's not the smartest bulb in the shed. He's street smart, but he's not people smart. He doesn't know how to read into people's actions. I'm a little bit better at that. I tell him, yo, this is exactly what's going on. I know exactly what's going on, dude. This is what he's trying to do. And so I kind of snap out on the gay dude. I'm like, yo, I know exactly what you're trying to do. This isn't cool. Oh, I didn't make it fuck. This isn't cool. Well, the dude gets mad at me. Says I'm a source of evil negative energy and everything. I'm like, and my boy, he tells me this too, and I'm like, dude, this isn't you talking. You never talk like that. You don't ever talk about no fucking energy and some shit like that. Like, not that that's a bad thing, but I'm like, yo, you never talk like that. Like, this isn't you. So, the gay dude, I finally have enough of it. Enough of bullshit, enough of the lies. I call the gay dude out. I'm like, yo, the only reason you don't like me is because you are fucking in love with him. You want him to be your boyfriend. Wake up and be gay one day. Be your fucking boyfriend. And I'm not having no parts of it. Well, he didn't like that. Because he was trying to get my boy addicted. And he hated me. Because I knew what he was doing. He was trying to get my dude addicted, and trying to make him fall in love with him. He followed him from Florida all the way up here to have some type of weird relationship with him, even though my dude isn't gay. Well, the gay dude didn't like this, and he didn't like the fact that my boy, was loyal to me. And so he pretty much is like, yo, fuck you. If you keep hanging out with him, I will not give you dope anymore. And so we no longer hang out. We are no longer friends. And that is what I mean by it's disgusting to see what friendship has become, because it seems to be all drug-based anymore, and it is disgusting. Like, because I won't give him dope and don't condone his abuse and call them out on their bullshit, I am now the bad guy. I am now the one who caused drama. And that is what I talk about. Well, that is what I mean when I talk about friendship isn't what it used to be. Because had drugs not been involved, had it been in a different time where everybody's not so self-centered and self-absorbed, things might have not gone down that way. But sadly, they did, and that is what happened. And that is my talk about friendship. It's that nobody truly cares anymore. It's all a matter of what they want. And I guess you could have the argument that if they were like that in the first place, then they weren't your friends to begin with. But once, in my opinion, once you get so used to getting something for so long, you're going to turn that way no matter what. And if you have that train of thought, then that would mean everybody's a bad person, and it gets into a whole willpower control thing. And yeah, that was my talk about friendship. So all in all, I pretty much had a best friend. We were best friends for a long time. He got addicted, moved away, went to rehab. I stayed here, took him in when he came back because he burned all his bridges. And the guy he was down there with now is in love with him and realizes how much he's in love with him. Follows him back here, gives him heroin again, gets him addicted. And then says, oh, by the way, if you stay Ian's friend, no more heroin for you. And that is what I mean by people using other people to get what they want. And it's disgusting what friendship has turned into. Because the gay dude is plainly in love with my best friend, and my best friend doesn't care because he gets heroin out of it. Well, him and his girlfriend. And I know you can say my whole theory is defeated by him having a girlfriend. That girlfriend is also bisexual, and they kind of have the same sex love bond going on, and they are also addicts, and they both love Sam the same way, and yes, they have all had sex together. And that is what I'm, and that, my friends, is what defeats the purpose of that argument. Anyway, that is my talk about friendship and how I'm just flabbergasted and disgusted at what it's become. How people aren't loyal to others anymore, and it's all about getting what somebody else wants. which is kind of gross. Oh. But it's just sad to see what has become of the world and what other people truly think of other people. But yeah. People don't care, man. They don't care. As long as people get what they want, they don't care anymore. And that is what I'm talking about when I say friendship has just gone down the drain. Because as long as you're giving somebody something, or somebody's getting something out of you, they will love you until the end of time. As soon as you stop giving, and there's nothing else to take, watch how fast people stop being your friend. Ooh, I forgot about you. That is what kind of aggravates me about the world. Because I guess my theory is that if you are someone's friend, it shouldn't matter what you can get out of them. It's just their presence should be enough, in my opinion, to keep you satisfied. Or to keep that friendship, I don't know what I'm trying to say, to keep that friendship going. This is another shortcut we just unlocked. But yeah, that is my best friendship, no longer friend story. And it sucks and it's sad what people will do to get what they want, but at the same time, what can you do? You know what I mean? Nothing I can do about it. Nothing at all. I can only observe and give my thoughts on what I think is going to happen and tell it how it is. And people don't like when you tell it how it is. People hate that shit. They don't want to hear the truth. People rather hear a pleasant lie than the blunt truth. And that's another thing that is extremely annoying in my opinion, because I ain't got no reason to lie. Fucking need to lie to you for. If somebody, I'd rather somebody tell me the truth than fucking lie to me. And I don't understand why it's different for other people. I don't understand why people would rather get lied to than know the truth, no matter how much it hurts them. Care the who, what, why, when, or how, but I'd like to know why, or if they even are. Hold on, is this still here? There was like a magic glitch spot right around here that would give you full health. Nah, I guess they took that out. Oh well. Oh, Shadows of Yharnam, but I had no bullets. I has no bullets. No bullets, Willis. Okay, well, I think we're gonna go back to the Hunter's Dream right now. And, I'm gonna level up real quick, then I'm gonna run back through here and do the Shadows of Yharnam. But yeah, that is kind of my friendship rant and story, and I'm sorry if it was, long and annoying. But I just kind of wanted to talk about the things I see around me and how they aggravate me and how things really aren't what they used to be. And I guess I sound like an old man, but I'm not, which is whatever. because, I mean, I'm only 23 years old, but still, I don't know, man. Even from when I was growing up, shit is mad different, and it's upsetting. And maybe that's why I'm so nihilistic, and...
Very well, let me...
Yeah, maybe that's why I am so nihilistic and do not really care. Well, I don't want to say don't really care, but don't really have much faith in the human race. I guess just because the things I see around me just are annoying and upsetting. But, man, what do I know? Let's get the Kirk hammer out, baby. Oh, I can fortify too. Or blood gems. Well, I guess if that's all we got. Okay, so 7-3. Well, that's all that one. What is that? 5-3. 5-4. I guess it doesn't really give to him. Well, we got that slow poison effect now. And apparently we have HP up. Oh, really? What a weird combination of blood gems and whatnot. I haven't used the Kirk hammer at all, really. I wonder if it can be buffed. It can be. Ooh, I kind of want to use my Kirk hammer for this fight, for my Yharnam Shadows fight. But yeah, first time I fought Shadows of Yharnam, whooped my ass. They straight whooped my ass the first time I fought them. And they kept doing it, 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 and it was so freaking annoying. I got so mad. So mad. So frustrated. So upset. And it's so cool that I don't have to worry about my rolls in this game. Boom, got the hammer, bad boy. The irony is not lost. I've never really used the Kirk hammer before. I know it has like the same moveset as the sword. But... I wonder if I can fall down there and not die. Huh. Oh well. Sorry, bud. We out. Oh no. Oh no, is he still coming for us? No, their aggro ranges really aren't that long in this game. And I'm cool in my charge set. In my charge set. My Charizard set. Here we go. Like a boss.
Look at Rose the boss. They remain off the sauce.
Gonna run through here. Skirt. Thanks, bud. Yeah, I haven't fought Shadows of Yharnam in quite some time, so I don't know how good I'm going to do, but we can try. Yeah, bye, Piggly Wiggly. Let's see if I can outrun him. Looks like it. Oh, God. Stuck on a tree branch. Just like real life. No! Physics! No! I know he can make it through there. I glitched that out before. That was not fun. Now let's see if I can do this fight. I should probably put out my cigarette. Alright, let's see if we can do this. See, I fight this fight a lot differently than most people. I like to take out the caster first. Whoa! Wow, that did not work out at all, whatsoever. Whoa, that sucked. I got just stunlocked and died, and that was not fun. I hate being stunlocked. That is the one thing I hate about this game. Stunlock is not nice. It is not a nice thing. It is one of the most depraved things that the developers can think of. The most depraved, actually, in my opinion. Because you can't move, you can't do nothing, you stand there and die like a bitch. And it's so bad. It hurts my feelings. It hurts my feelings so bad to be stunlocked. Makes me feel useless and inept. Useless and inept. And I know I didn't do the bloody beggar NPC. Because I actually want to test something. I want to see if I can come back through and get the bloody beggar. Or not. Like the Victoria environment a little more than I enjoy Dark Souls environment. I don't know why. I just like the Victorian setting a little bit more. But I don't know, that's just me. Like, I like a Victorian setting, but I like a middle age style play, if that makes sense. Now, let's see if I don't get fucked up like a little girl again. Like that little helpless messenger child, bloodstained messenger child. Dun dun dun. Oh, the fog. It's no longer in Bullet's area now. It's all the way out in Yharnam. Let's do this. Alright. So, no shields to block. Quick little cut.
a running gun this fight.
No, 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 no. One thing I do not like about lock-on. Yes, much faster gear. God damn! They hold aggro like no other. Demons. Hate these guys. He's gonna do it again. See, I hate the caster. The caster is such a pain for me. Now that these guys are all fucked up, I think I kind of fucked myself. But I don't know for a fact. So let's do this. I just gotta stay out of range. Because they got their long attacks now, I believe. Now, oh, I forgot I had this. Call me while I was running. Alright, let's see if I can get these guys. I hate this fight so much. But see, I like to take out the caster first. So that way, I don't have to worry about getting all fudged up by the constant fireballs that are all up in my face. And then I like to take out this guy, because he is just a yucky butthole. Let's see if I can get all of him in his face. And then this dude, I like to just get in his face then. And you don't let him call the thingamabob, you don't let him call the snake, and then just chop him up like that. And that is like, that is how I like to do that fight. And I got a silly little death, but it's all good because it wanted to be a silly goose egg. And then I think we're going to return to the Hunter's Dream and call it a day. But yeah, so that is my rant on friendship, and that is my rant, basically. So I'm going to get the big old hammer out, and I will catch you guys on the flip side.